Ewan Sigrun, how was it you first spoke?
Back when Freya was queen in Asgard, the better times, I mean, there really began to be some culture around the place. Poets, musicians, the odd contortionist would pay visits, perform, mingle. On one occasion, I'd taken a seat expecting to see this balladeer of the lowlands, when Sigrun walked in, somehow more stunning than I'd ever seen her. And when of all places she chose to sit next to me, well, a lot of very interesting things happened very quickly. But I may need to collect my thoughts while you get us killed again.
Let us get back to your memories of Sigrun. She sat beside you.
Yes, she chose to sit next to me.
No big thing, really.
Yet, somehow, despite myself, I felt her rush in my stomach like I was a green lad again. Embarrassing at the end of the day, to be so simple. I made some remark, and I learned how it felt to make her laugh. And suddenly I felt more at ease. Almost eerily so. A calm within each other's storms, I suppose.
They had a way of describing that. Peace is among us.
Lovely, brother. That's exactly right.
Thank you. I believe your target's on the battlefield there.
Valhalla will be impressed. Pass should be unlocked now, shall we? Brother, the choice you were given? To stay in Elysium with your daughter only to perish? Sounds like no choice at all.
Of course it was a choice. One I wish many times I'd made differently.
How so?
When I left Greece, Calliope was never far from my mind. I do not know how much time we would have had together in Elysium, but I would have traded the decades that followed for mere hours with her. It took meeting Faye for that feeling to go away, along with Calliope's song. But I do still think of her in Elysium, and hope she found peace.
I knew you couldn't resist the challenge.
Kratos! It's been not nearly long enough.
Huh.
one you need to slay. Incoming charge! Disrupted, you halfwit! Things just got harder. Did you forget that haste is a factor here? Whoa! Watch your right, moron! Behind you! Incoming! Now that's the Kratos that brought down Atlas. Coming left side! Incoming!
I suppose this means you didn't get to Tyr. Sorry, brother.
I can continue my story now.
Shield Maiden.
Excellent. Valhalla sees you, recognizes your growth. Keep going. I can continue my story now.
I am listening.
If you'll remember, my teacher had fallen ill. Everything she taught me, I poured into trying to save her. But it turned out mage healing wasn't enough. I realized that only a combination of mage healing and herbal traditions could save her. But I'd let my knowledge of the herbal arts fade away. And so, I failed her like I failed him. And she passed into Hell's embrace. It took a long time to get over that. Anyway, I'll stop here for now. Be a river, flowing and adapting to any shape, any circumstance.
Do you feel more complete than when you started?
Now these would make a real and lasting difference.
It is all too common to fall to one of the chosen enemies of Valhalla. Don't lose heart.
got it.
You found the pendant of a necklace. Fancy.
I will tell you the pendant story soon. Mamir, you may speak more of Contos.
Right. Where were we? After the ice was broken, we fell to talking more regularly, even making a point to do so. It was all I could do to enjoy our company responsibly, staying mindful of our respective positions and keep from crossing any line that would make things difficult for us to recover from.
Wise.
Well, mostly. I'm always wisest in the parts I let myself remember. It exacts a toll. It might be worth it. Seems Valhalla won't let you that way unless you strike a bargain.
Your way!
happened next with Sigrun?
She had introduced me as a good friend. And though I couldn't be entirely sure what she meant by it, for once I wasn't concerned with an outcome. Regarding Sigrun, I knew my answer was yes. The question itself seemed secondary.
You were not upset she called you friend.
Show me someone who friendship means lack of love, and I'll show you someone who wonders why their lovers never end up being worth their time.
Perhaps. But you did not express your feelings.
Oh. I don't think she could have escaped noticing them. I just never asked her anything I felt sure she'd have to refuse. This choice may hurt a little.
Your relationship with Sigrun. Why so reluctant to tell her how you felt?
She was on the Valkyrie's path, preparing to transcend her corporeal form. That was her focus, her chosen purpose, and I didn't want to suggest myself as an obstacle. I suppose I let some part of myself imagine she might recognize my affection, even reciprocate it. But now that we know what she was running from, obviously she'd never again risk choosing love over duty. A unique, heartfelt friendship, that is what could endure, and that is what I chose to embrace. certainly earned that pledge. Splendid. I think we're free and clear to take the way up now. It may be just for this try, but a little assist would be nice. Pendant you found, brother. Do you recognize it? Does it have some significance?
Yes. It belonged to my wife.
It was Faye's?
No. My first wife, Lysandra.
Ah, I see. You know, brother, you've told me a great deal about your daughter, Calliope. But her mother is a bit of a mystery.
My thoughts on her are complicated. But she was a good woman, and I loved her more than she knew. She saw in me possibilities I could not at the time. In that way, she and Faye were much alike.
Hello, me again. Aren't you?